Hello traders, welcome back to our YouTube channel. In this video, we are going to have our stock request session. We do this regularly and I post this publicly on our FB page so anyone can comment with their requested stocks. However, this session will be quick one dahil konti lang ang nag-request ng kanilang mga watchlist. Again, disclaimer lang for the ones who are new in this channel that you may or may not agree with my market opinion. And it is totally fine with me. We are doing this just to help you give some inputs and hopefully we can give you clarity on the stocks that you are eyeing on. If you really think that the stocks you intended to buy eh talagang tataas, then do so. Buy it no matter how I disagree with your vision. First off, let's start on studying our market index. And as you can see, nag-end last Friday ng strong bearish candlestick. And take note, may volume, above average ang volume. So, hindi natin alam kung bakit siya nagkaroon ng breakdown dito sa near 7,000 points level. However, there is a large possibility na magtuloy-tuloy to for next week and it might challenge the 6,800 level at kung hindi mag-hold yung previous na support dito sa may 6,800 level, the index might challenge up to 6,600 level. However, kung magkaroon naman ng positive market sentiment next week, the very challenge that our index would face is to breach the 7,200 level to close the gap in between of 7,200 level up to 7,300 level. So kung nakita nyo, merong nangyaring gap down to, pwedeng i-fill up niya, pero kung kailan, hindi natin masasabi yun, yung exact definite date kung kailan niya i-fill yun. So let's start off with our first requestor na si Boss Edmond FCG daw, or Figaro Coffee Group. So kung makikita mo, yung stock na ito, wala pa rin good entry point as of this point in time kung nagbabalak kang bumili nito. And kung nakabili ka on the IPO price itself, medyo delikado ka kasi as of right now, you are incurring around negative 25% in loss. So medyo hindi ko alam kung ano yung dapat mong gawin kasi hindi ko alam kung saan mo siya nabili. Is it around 1 pesos per share? Kasi kung around 1 pesos per share, you are currently losing more than 40%, almost. Or kung sa IPO price or dito sa bounce, hindi natin masabi. But right now, I do not see a good potential entry point for us to make money in FCG. However, kung meron kang sariling diskarte or stock methodology na you think you can make money on this trade, then go on. So let's proceed doon sa mga mining stocks na diniscuss natin a few weeks ago. Let's see kung meron na bang mga good entry points sila NIKL, FNI, and etc. So let's start off with NIKL. Etong si NIKL, after ng sabihin nating reversal dito, kasi hindi na to basta-basta pullback or correction, so medyo we can call it reversal, nagkaroon siya ng bounce dito for around 8% gain. However, I think the bounce will not sustain. Pwede dalawa lang ang mangyari, mag-sideways siya in the range of 7.5 up to 8.15 pesos per share or pwede magkaroon na ng lower low or lower high and it will challenge the 8.62 pesos per share kung hindi mag-hold itong 7.5 in confluence to MA50. So pwedeng bumagsak, tapos hahalikan niyo MA50, tapos dito magkaroon ng bounce. Let's see kung what's happen next. So kung hindi pa rin to mag-hold, more likely baka bumalik na to sa 6.34 pesos per share, which is our previous entry point na banda rito. So again, NIKL, I do not see a good entry point. Pwera na lang kung you are a day trader or scalper and you think you can make money on doing that one, then go for it. Next, we study the stock of FNI. Medyo mas pangit nga lang yung chart structure ni FNI and still, I do not see a good entry point for FNI. So overall, I would say na avoid lang muna with FNI and look for another stock na medyo attractive and has a good risk-reward ratio. Next stock, we study the stock dito. Kung makikita mo, nagkakaroon lang siya ng range between 6.2 pesos per share down to around 4.82 pesos per share. So ito yung nagiging significant support niya at ito yung nagiging significant resistance niya. At kung medyo malakas ang loob mo, medyo mahaba ang pasensya mo for range trading, pwede ito yung gawin mo, buy on here, sell on resistance, buy on here, sell on resistance. So parang ang nangyayari, nagiging sideways lang siya. However, there is a little possibility nga lang na magkaroon ng bounce dito sa may 4.82 pesos per share and i-challenge niya itong resistance at 6.2 pesos per share. Kasi kunwari merong negative market sentiment, baka hindi na niya kayanin itong 4.82 pesos per share na i-support at magkaroon ng breakdown at tumuloy-tuloy na pababa. So yun lang naman yung risk kay dito, and for me, if you will ask me if I will trade this, medyo hindi ako confident to trade this, although there is a little potential kasi unang-una, the probability is very low, and pangalawa, baka kapag trinade ko to, mag-antay ako na matagal, sabihin natin 1 month, 2 months, in order for me to realize my profit. So medyo sabihin natin tagilid ako, and if meron akong makitang mas magandang stock na could make me money, na mas okay ang chance or probability rate, and in a shorter period of time, yun yung itatrade natin. Next and last stock, we will discuss SPNEC. Kasi a few days ago, nagkaroon siya ng bounce. And as you can see here, dito banda sa 1.56 pesos per share, nagkaroon siya ng doji, sign of reversal, and kinabukasan, nagkaroon ng gap up, and it ended up with around 14% gain and another 3% gain noong Friday. So right now, wala pa rin ako nakikitang good opportunity to trade SPNEC. So again, stay on the sidelines. However, kung meron kang sariling trading methodology again to trade SPNEC, then go for it. So ayun lang, I hope I have given you clarity sa mga stocks na binabantayan ninyo or mga watchlist ninyo. And if you find this channel very helpful to you, please don't forget to hit the subscribe button and ring the bell so that you will be notified pag may mga bagong video tayo na ina-upload katulad nito na nagtuturo tayo para sa inyo. Good night and God bless.